Hello and welcome to another edition of the Moving Iron Podcast. This podcast is proudly provided by Axon, helping dealers move more iron for almost 100 years. Find out more at axontire.com. Axon was started almost 100 years ago out of a passion for keeping agriculture moving. It's that same passion that drives them today. With a vision for a better experience for both farmer and dealer, they set out to create a better way to move more iron. When you partner with Axon, you get immediate access to a full range of products and solutions designed to meet the complex needs of today's grower. Axon carries all major brands and sizes of tires, wheels, and tracks. From custom colors and sizes to fully customized wheels, you can have the solution for virtually any problem today's farmer is trying to solve. To find more or become an Axon dealer, please visit axontire.com. Moving iron in the 21st century. Hardworking people working hard for you and me.
Time and time again, through the years you'll find us here, moving iron. Hey everyone, it's Jacqueline Kramowski with the Herdbook Ag Media, giving you your Moving Iron Ag News update for this final week of April 2021. Starting out with our politics for this week, one of the big news coming from Capitol Hill has been the reintroduction of the Dairy Pride Act by Senators Tammy Baldwin and Jim Risch. This bipartisan action would combat what is, quote-unquote, the unfair practice of mislabeling non-dairy products using dairy names. That means that the purpose of this is to call on the Food and Drug Administration to start enforcing the standards that say exactly what should qualify as things like dairy, butter, milk, etc., that currently a lot of these dairy alternative products have been labeling their products as, even though it has technically not legal according to the current FDA guidelines. Also happening in the Senate is the Growing Climate Solutions Act. And this bill, which is again going back to that voluntary carbon markets that the Biden administration has been working to push through, just passed through the Senate Ag Committee and is going to now go to the floor for consideration. Essentially, this act is getting more input from farmers, ranchers, and landowners to discuss exactly how this carbon market would work, the regulations, who would qualify, etc., in response to some previous concerns that there would be equity issues in the way that these markets were currently being proposed. Thus far, this act has had a lot of support from both the ag and environmental sides of the discussion, and likely assuming that the momentum keeps up to pass. Also this month, U.S. Congress passed the Food Allergy Safety Treatment Education and Research Act of 2021, which interestingly adds sesame to be the ninth major food allergen and will need to be reported on labels as such. This means that sesame will join other major allergens already currently having to be labeled as such, including milk, eggs, fish, shellfish, tree nuts, peanuts, soybeans, and wheat. All right, hopping over to some of our international news this week. Bulgaria had to cull another 40,000 of their laying hens, again, due to the avian bird flu outbreak. This will be the fifth case yet to hit the nation. As new farm equipment demand continues to soar, a lot of equipment makers are having a hard time meeting demands, still reeling from production slowdowns in the wake of COVID-19. Overall, tractor sales have gone up as high as 81% last month compared to last year, and over 60,000 tractors in all categories across the board have sold in 2021, which is another 52% increase. Even combine sales have gone up within the first quarter of 2021 by nearly 20%. Manufacturers are facing the tightest equipment supply in North America in the last 18 years as they struggle to keep up with supplies. Unsurprisingly, this is causing some of our manufacturers to move away from U.S. production and to start outsourcing more overseas. Moving a little closer to home in our national news, Tyson Fresh Meats, which is the beef and pork subsidiary of Tyson Foods, Inc., recently announced that they are voicing their support for the cattle disease traceability program, U.S. Cattle Trace. As such, they will be the first beef processor to invest in the program, and to work on doing their part to develop the national infrastructure for disease traceability in the cattle sector. And speaking of corporate investments, ag tech continues to be very hot. Most recently, one of the interesting innovations has been finding autonomous robotic vehicles specifically designed to plant and prep soil for potatoes, all without any human intervention. And as ag tech continues to move, so does the protein market, as the insect protein sector is slated to reach 500,000 tons by the year 2030 as productions continue to grow, with some potential to also be an input in animal feed as well as protein for people. Despite the impact felt by COVID, both the food and agriculture-related industries continue to be a major employer of people in the United States, as well as a serious economic factor. A recent study found that even despite the pandemic, food and agriculture industries continue to employ about 19.3 million Americans, who, with their wages and benefits combined, are total about $683.45 billion U.S. dollars. This study also found that employment in food and agriculture industries was equivalent to about 13% of all U.S. employment. In total, this adds nearly $3 trillion to the U.S. economy on an annual basis. All right, that catches you all up for this week and the month of April. This Ag News Update is brought to you by the Herdbook Ag Media, serving all your agribusiness writing, communication, and media needs. Find us on Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, or our company website, the-herdbook.com. Let me know you found me here at Moving Iron, and I'll give you 20% off your first invoice.
You want to have a meaningful, competitive advantage to help sell more equipment. Whether you represent the sales, parts, or management department of an implement dealership, there's a surprising amount of complexity when it comes to tire, wheel, and track technology. Let Axon worry about that so you can get back to supporting your customers. Axon has leveraged years of experience to create a streamlined process that gives you a proven path to help today's grower and sell more equipment. The roots of their organization go back almost 100 years to the invention of the rubber tractor tire. Supporting agriculture is the number one driver of Axon, from product development through sales and service. To find more or become an Axon dealer, head over to axontire.com.
Moving iron in the 21st century. Hardworking people working hard for you and me. Time and time again, through the years you'll find us here.